it's all could have been avoided, but they decided to make us so embarrassed, create such a scene, humiliate us for no reason.
Crystal Ali arrived at Pearson International Airport early this morning with her two-year-old daughter and her best friend. They were to catch a flight back home to the British Virgin Islands.
It was supposed to be a happy return home, but it turned into a travel nightmare. Crystal forced to wait hours for another flight after she says her and her daughter were unfairly removed from their WestJet flight this morning.
When I got on board, basically an airline stewardess overheard me saying that the seats were uncomfortable for my daughter, who wasn't feeling so great. And he proceeded to ask me probing questions into her health care as to, you know, what she had and why it would be unsafe for her to fly. And I told him that as her mother, I took her to the doctor, made sure that it was safe for her to do so, and the doctor cleared her to fly.
But it turned out that wasn't good enough. Ali says she was then approached by other attendants who asked her more questions about her daughter.
They just kept saying that that we may not be able to take the flight. And then eventually we were told that we were to get off the plane because she was not well enough to fly.
She says WestJet called the family's doctor to confirm, but only after she, her two-year-old daughter, and her best friend were kicked off the flight. They were then rebooked on a flight with a different airline in the evening, one with more layovers and one that required them to stay in a hotel. No compensation for additional expenses.
I have seen recently, just in the past few months, a number of incidents like this, and it's unfortunate that WestJet is not cracking down on such power tripping by its own crew. The flight attendants are not doctors. There was no medical advice based on which they were acting. In other words, they were acting arbitrarily based on guesswork.
Air passenger rights advocate Gabor Lukash says it would have been different if a medical doctor had been consulted before they were removed from the flight. In the absence of that, he says, the passengers do have a right to be compensated.
This is simply a case of denied boarding. The passenger was removed from the flight without any justification, and WestJet will have to compensate the passenger for all the damages caused.
For Ali, what makes the ordeal even harder to handle is knowing that she was supposed to be flying back home to the British Virgin Islands to reunite with her husband for good. Over a year ago, they were among the many who lost their homes as Hurricane Irma ripped through the region.
It was devastating. It's been a rough year. Just, you know, that's why this was such an amazing moment, because we've been through so much this past year, and we're finally getting back to the place that we love and going to get to finally be together as a family, start the new year together.
City News reached out to WestJet for comment. In a statement, they wrote in part, "When our crews observe a guest who is exhibiting signs of not being fit to fly, we will, out of an abundance of caution and in adherence with Transport Canada's regulations, remove the guest from the flight." They also added, "We stand by our crew's decision and believe that what we have offered to this guest is reasonable under the circumstances."